Knowing this knowledge made me a couple of millions to myself. I want us to take time and speak about what is it that I know, what is it that I knew, and what did I apply, and what steps did I take in order of me to be able to make those numbers. At first, guys, you do know that I started trading, or I don't know, I forgot the age, but I started trading actually at 2017. And at that time, you know, things were tough back home and everything. I even noticed, like, you know, when I was just, I'm working on a very big project of myself. And I noticed when I was giving information about the project that, you know, some of the things that I had gone through are much more deeper than I had shared. I've never told my story fully to the world. So I won't take time on this video talking about my story. There'll be a project where you'll be able to find out more about my story and see what are the things that I was able to walk through. But now, on this video, what I want to speak about is what is it that I started doing in order of me to, you know, break into the seven-figure mark. I made my first million at the age of 22 years old. And a few months later, that's when I made my second, and you know, the numbers started to just grow more and more numbers started to show up. But you know, I didn't even notice, because most people are like, how did it feel when you made a million? I didn't notice that, you know, I made it. I wasn't looking at that exact moment when it jumped into a million. I was just putting in the work, I was just hustling, doing whatever that I can do. And one day when I was just looking at my numbers, that's when I was like, oh, I've made more than this. This is where I'm actually at. Oh, okay, no, there's progress. I can see there's a way forward. That's how I came about to understanding that, okay, no, I really did break these numbers. But now, guys, the first thing that I actually did do here is that I'm going to be speaking in step-by-step form. So obviously, if you stay up until the very end, that's when you'll get the whole steps then. So the first thing that I done here is that I started off with structurizing a detailed plan of what it is that I want, what is it that I am going to do, what dreams, what passions am I going to be chasing. I had that detailed plan when I was still in college. So by my very last month of college, I sat down and I was like, you know what? This is what I want. I want to see myself doing this, having these numbers that are coming into my account each and every single month. I want to see this. I want to see myself living here. I want to see myself doing, like, I structured a detailed plan. Obviously, you don't know what business model you're going to be involved in that's going to help you get to that plan. So you don't need to worry too much about that. Most people fail to take the first step because they are worried too much on, I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know if I'm going to cut the green, or if I'm going to sell cars, or if I'm going to trade. Don't think too much about it. Just have a detailed plan of what do you want? Where do you want to see yourself in the next few months? Where do you want to see yourself in the next few years? Have a detailed plan. Sit down and then think about it. The most important thing should be your why. You should have a detailed plan that has a strong why. Knowing that each and everything, whatever that happens, your why should be the one thing that pushes you. So I structured my things. You know, I remember one of the things that I've done is that I started off by creating a vision board. I still have vision boards till this day. Obviously, my vision boards are now bigger. I had vision boards back then of, you know, A45 here. I had vision boards of a BMW 3 Series here, not even M3, BMW 3 Series here and stuff. Now my vision boards is like Ferraris, big houses, all these things, you know, but it's nothing. So you have to start off by having a vision board, structurizing down. I remember one of the things that I also done in order to see finances in the real life is that I saw one of my dad's bank thingy, receipt, whatever slip was he had. He spent some money somewhere else and all those things. So his available balance was like 20,000 rands. I was like, yo, it'll be nice to see 20,000 rands in my bank account. So I took his slip and then I put it on my vision board. It's like, let me just keep it there. And then after doing exactly that, you know, obviously, you know, a few months, I was able to, you know, attract those numbers to myself. I was able to attract 20,000 and more. But even now what I've done is that the numbers that I'm seeing now, I literally went into my dashboard, my FNB dashboard. As soon as I got there, what I've done is that I printed out what my dashboard looks like, and then I cancelled out my numbers on my dashboard, and then I put down the numbers that I want to see, and then I printed that out, and then I put it on my vision board. So you see big numbers and you'll be like, yeah. So even me, when I see, I was like, yeah, this is my name, this everything, all this, this much in this account, this much in this account. Oh, okay, like it becomes a normal thing. So I'm getting used to seeing that. So that's one of the things that I also done. But the most important thing that I done here is that I created a vision board, a plan. I didn't know it was a plan. I didn't know it was a vision board. I just thought that I want to do this. Like, that's how it was for me. And I was drawing at that time. So when I was still in college, I was drawing and all these things. So while drawing, luckily at school, you know, when you draw, you get these, A2, is it A2, these bigger ones, you know, these big ones. And I got the benefits of having those papers. So I was able to use the paper, not to draw in school, but to actually write down my plans and stuff. So those are one of the things that I actually done. And just having a structured plan at the end of the day, guys, have a detailed structured plan. That is the first one. So now the second one that I want us to discuss here is that it's very important for you to understand, you know, where it is that you're going. Eh? So where it is that you're going is like, you know, a clear direction of like, what you're gonna achieve. If you're seeing where you're going, you're gonna be able to understand what you're gonna achieve. So I done that, and one thing that I done is that I was able to fix and develop my morning routine. Develop a morning routine. Once you develop a morning routine, guys, that's when everything's gonna change, because the way you start your day is the way you go about with your day, is the way you continue with your day. Once you start your day in a nicer manner, that's when, you know, if you start in a productive way, that's when you're gonna be more productive during the day, throughout the day, and even at the end of the day. So develop a morning routine. So what actually could a morning routine be like? What actually could a morning routine be like? So like, for instance, come take a look at this. So these are my goals. Okay, let me just cut down here. These are some of my personal goals. Today's goals, 21, you can simply see, come forward so they can see, you know, affirm, pray, work out, meditate. So no matter what, like each and every day I do this, I read book, this my goal day, I read book, you know, these things that I do. That's my morning. If I don't pray in the morning and I go through my day, I'm gonna feel like I missed something. Something is not going well with my life. So develop a morning routine, guys. Whatever routine it is for you, work out, do this, go take a walk, jog, develop a habit that you're gonna follow on a consistent basis. Once you get that done, you are steps closer to your goals. I wouldn't say 80% or 50%, but you are steps closer. Remember, yeah, I'm giving you steps that help me reach some of my goals and move forward in life. Even till this day, I'm still applying them because I've got more goals that I need to achieve and all those things. So that's one of the things that actually helped me. So yes, develop a morning routine. So one of the third things that I've done, that is the second step. So one of the third things that I've done is that, like, you know, obviously, first step, second step, you need to apply these things specifically. Once you apply them, that's when you'll be able to see that, okay, no, my things are actually structured. My things, like, there's literally a clear way possible. So, here, let me just make sure this is not cutting out. This is not cutting out. Okay, sorry about that. But yes, one of the third things that I learned is that I initially started a business. You have to start a business. So yes, you can work a 9-to-5, you can do all these things, you can do what to... I've never worked a 9-to-5. Like I've never really, you know, been involved into, like, you know, work space and all those things. Like even here, this is basically like my first 9-to-5 job. Like, you know, being in my own office is like my first 9-to-5 jobs. If I never had this office, I was never gonna get a job ever in my life, because I have no qualifications. I have no knowledge towards whatever. Like, I literally am just, you know, a person, a mind and a body. So you need to start a business. So a business doesn't need to be something that's gonna make you a lot of money. A business needs to be something that's gonna bring you income. As simple as cutting loan, you know, washing cars, washing shoes, drawing for people, creating art for people. Start a business, bring some income, bring some capital. Bring some income, bring some capital. When once you start bringing in income and capital, that's when what you can do. Forex also is a business. Remember, forex trading is not just trading. It's a business. It's a business model. I got into forex. That was my path. That was my way out. You also can get your way out. So you have to start a business. And, you know, after obviously starting a business, what you have to do, that is the first step. The fourth step is, you know, you have to obviously invest more into yourself and your business. So what that means is that, like, firstly, speak about investing in yourself. You need to know the ups and downs of your business. You need to know, you need to become the best, like, you need to become the best in what you're doing. So if you decide that you want to be washing cars, be the best as that you can be. Get all the equipments. Don't try to be the best that you can be in washing cars. Know, you know, I should wash this say, and then I should put polish on, I should do the windows, I should do the interior, maybe after, then at the end I'll do the tires, I should do the engine too, then I should do the boot. Like, you know, have a detail, like, be the master of that. Invest more into yourself, and then also focus more on personal development, not only just about your business, but if, like, know yourself more, learn about yourself, know what are some of the things that you are going to be applying that's going to, you know, help you see a way forward. Like, learn more about yourself, become a better person, better individual.
And then obviously the other one that I did mention is that invest in your business. Get team members, people that want to help you do some things that you can't do anymore. You know, invest a bit more into that, invest more into equipment, invest more into, like, now we are trading here, we are also a brand that's pushing out there. So I had to invest in laptops, I had to invest in an office area which I pay a month, I had to invest in like screens, I had to invest in all these things, and I had to invest in team members, not because of the fact that I just feel like I want to invest, because of the fact that, you know, getting someone that has, like, when speaking about customer care and sales, I'm not good at selling, I'm not good at, you know, I won't have enough time to trade while also managing my clients. So I need someone that's gonna perfectly do that role for me. Do you understand? So you have to invest back into your business. Once you do something just like this, you're gone. Like, these are the steps. So far I gave you the first, second, third, and fourth. And the very last one, let me just confirm, okay. The very last one here is that you need to live below your means. So live below your means, meaning that, like, if you're making 100,000 a month, doesn't mean that you have to spend 100,000 a month. Live below your means. So what I do is that I'll go by the 30% rule. I normally pay myself less than even 30% of what I make. Like, I've got, like, you know, the money that I make, I've got, you know, multiple sources of income. So the money that I make is that, you know, it goes into one account, one business account, and then I get, you know, just a specific portion of that amount, and, you know, at the end, you know, I'm able to live with that. I'm able to live below my means. I know no matter what happens, this is how much I have to take home each and every month. So even if I want to spend a lot of money, this is how much I have to just focus on. Even if I make $100,000 on the markets, that's how much I'm getting at the end of each and every month. I'm living below my means. What does that allow me to do? It allows me to invest back into my business. I spend over hundreds of thousands of rands on my business each and every single month. Not because it's cost onto the, it's because I'm investing back into it. I know, and it keeps on coming back. It keeps on pumping money. I know I made this much from the markets, but, you know, you always see me not always just throwing big amounts of money for no reason. I've got a salary, I'm sorted. Whatever I make, it goes, I withdraw specific times, and then it goes, then I'm able to do my things. Understand? So you have to live below your means. So guys, those are the five steps. Make sure that you are subscribed and liked. Make sure that you are also, you know, you took down notes. If you haven't, it's okay, you can re-watch this video, but take down notes, sit down, think properly what it is that you're going to be doing, and comment below what you think about this exact knowledge that I did share with you guys, that allowed me to go from being just a broke kid that lived in the wood with no dreams, no future, nothing, to being something that I was able to create for myself. So I will see you on the next video. It's long to be here.